So I get to travel a lot. That can be, sometimes it can be great, sometimes it can be tiresome. You know, I was in North Dakota doing a show, and I was in a small town in North Dakota. It was steak and beer night at the VFW. Yeah, the whole town came to the show, and the whole town was wasted drunk. The mayor was drunk. The fire chief was drunk. The chief of police was drunk, and that was all the same person. I couldn't believe it. I was like, wow. Who is running this town? True story. I'm sitting down enjoying my steak and beer. Drunk guy leans forward and he says, I would love to smell a black woman. My friend gets up. He wants to fight the guy. I go, hold on. This could be material. Let's see what happens. Guy leans forward. He sniffs me. He goes, you smell so good. I said, well, we wash, you know. What were you expecting? Ribs, hickory, slavery? What you looking for here in North Dakota? I like you guys. I'm glad you laughed on that line. People get touchy at comedy clubs on that line. Told that joke down in Florida. Drunk woman stood up in the middle of my show. Slavery? Why you gotta say slavery? I go, ma'am, it's over. I's free. It's a joke. People are touchy when you talk about race. I know it, but I have to talk about it because it's something I'm very passionate about. I'm always amazed at the things I've heard. I live down south. I've heard more in the Midwest. I think it's so funny. I used to, when I lived in Minnesota, I used to work at a radio station, and I sold advertising. And back then, I was the only African-American in the sales office. And they used to always try to set me up on dates all the time. But whenever they said they found the perfect guy for me, that usually meant they didn't know the guy, but a black man just walked into the building downstairs. Never fail. I'd be at my desk. The receptionist, Val, she had the best intentions. She'd call, Tracy, the UPS man is here. I'm like, well, do I have a package? And she whispers, because he's standing right there, no, he's black. I thought you should know. I'm guilty of it too. I say things I shouldn't say. I didn't want to pay for parking. Another crazy true story happened here. I was going to run in and drop off a package for a friend. The guy who owned the lot owned the restaurant next door, and he was an Asian man. He came around the corner, broad daylight, and he had some kind of uniform or costume thing on. He had on a gray robe, a dragon belt, a beanie hat, and he actually had a long white beard. Broad daylight, he yells at me because he sees I'm not going to pay for parking. He goes, hey, you! You're no Parker here. And I'm an idiot, and that made me laugh right in the man's face. I said, what did you just say? You are adorable. What did you just say? He said, you're no Parker here. Sir, I'm sorry. I'm going to run in and run out. I'll be right back. No, I call cop. I tow your car. And it flew out of my mouth before I could stop myself. I was like, whatever, Mr. Miyagi, whatever. I'll be inside. Why don't you go wax on, wax off somewhere? Tell you, it was like this man waited for this moment his entire life. Without missing a beat, he came right back. Okay, Aunt Jemima. I was like, oh no, you did. We had a stereotype off right there in broad daylight. It's like, you fried rice eater. He came right back, you fried chicken eater. And he went like this, bring it. I couldn't think of anything. So I was like, think of old TV shows from when you were a kid. I was like, you mash extra. I started making helicopter noises. He started laughing. He's like, that's pretty good. I like that one. And then we started making out right there in the parking lot. We started making out. It was fun. At the end of that story, I used to say, and now our son Tiger is kicking ass. But I stopped because when I was in North Dakota, there was a woman who wanted to know if that was true. Yeah, I'm nowhere near old enough to be the mother of Tiger Woods. And secondly, things would have to be going really bad for Tiger for his mom to be at the VFW in North Dakota. Use their brains.